Hello, I am Dr. Gautam Dash. I am working over here in Barasat District Hospital and working as a consultant neurologist in Narayana Super Speciality Hospital. I want to share a few words about epilepsy with you. Epilepsy is a group of neurological disorders that comprises and clinically characterizes by the seizures, and it occurs in different age populations of people. In developed countries, it is usually affects the or usually the infants and elderly people, and in developing countries like us, usually the older children and the younger adults are usually affected. In epilepsy, there is hypersynchronous excessive stimulation from the cortical neuron, and that is nerve cells, and that gives rise to epilepsy, that is manifested as seizures and motoric convulsions. The cause of most epilepsy is unknown. But in some cases, there are some underlying causes like brain tumor, trauma, and degenerative diseases, some infections. These are the underlying causes of some epilepsies. And these epilepsies should be differentiated from other causes which can give rise to some manifestations which mimics the epileptic seizures, like fainting, like syncope, that gives rise due to some cardiac causes. And also there are some diseases that gives rise to some manifestations that mimic epilepsy, like alcohol withdrawal, substance abuse disorders. These are the cases that may be sometimes very similar to the epileptic features. Now we diagnose this case of epilepsy most commonly with the clinical features, but it is associated with some changes in the laboratory features and some electroencephalographic features also. So that's we manifested it in the EEG, some change in the electrical graphs, and those are the changes that is manifested in the graph. Seizures are most commonly manageable with the medications. Sometimes the medicines are not as very good, and at that time we use surgery or at some time neurostimulation to reduce these epileptic seizures. About 1% of the population, that is about approximately 65 million of the peoples, suffered from the epilepsy worldwide, and about 80% of these people are living in the developing countries. So, and the difference between the epidemiology in developing countries and developed countries and their age incidence is due to the differences in the underlying causes of the epilepsy. The word epilepsy comes from the ancient Greek word, which means to take possession of or to seize, possess or to affect. Now the signs and symptoms of the epilepsy are like these. Initially the person has some contractions of the all groups of muscles, and it persists, and it is followed by some contraction of extensor groups of the muscles and associated with arching of the body and the neck muscles, and it persists for 8 to 10 seconds, which is followed by the violent shaking movements of the whole body musculatures, and this is called as tonic movements. And apart from following these tonic and clonic feats, there are some people take some time to regain its normalcy. It takes about 5 to 10 minutes. So in totality it takes 15 to 13 minutes time to in this the person takes from seizure to normalcy, to return to normalcy from seizure. After this seizure, the patient, when regained normalcy, he becomes some about a little bit about confused, and there is disability to speak, there may be some headache, there may be some confusion. So this is called some post-epileptic state. This is about some generalized epilepsy. Regarding classification, we classify this epilepsy broadly into groups. One is generalized seizure and another is partial seizure. Generalized seizure is seizure that occurs due to electrical discharges that arise from both the cerebral hemispheres. In case of partial seizures, the cerebral discharges usually arises from the cingulate hemisphere. And these partial seizures, sometimes these partial seizures may develop or may extend to involve both the hemisphere, and that is called partial seizure continuity generalization. And during the classification, the generalized seizure is again classified into tonic, tonic-clonic, atonic, myoclonic, absence. These are the seizure types. And the secondary seizures, they're seizures due to some other causes that gives rise to seizure, the secondary causes. Maybe due to brain tumor, maybe infection, substance abuse, some degenerative disorders, some demyelinating disease. So these are the diseases that may give rise to seizures. The seizure and epilepsy are not the same modes. The seizure is the occurrence of the clinical manifestations of convulsion and other abnormalities in behavior, in speech, like that. And seizure, when it recurs, it causes epilepsy. And seizure is usually sometimes due to the secondary diseases, and epilepsy most of the time it is idiopathic, that is no cause can be obtained and can be obtained from these cases of epilepsy. So some psychological and social aspects that are associated with epilepsy. The patients with epilepsy have some got psychological disturbances, there may be confusion, there may be some psychosis, and the patients also associated with depression, attention deficit disorder. The children with epilepsies are affected with learning disabilities, particularly when they are affected in the growing period, and there may be poor achievement in the academics, and these are the effects that affects the people socially and also culturally. And regarding the culture, when we think of some cultural aspect of the epilepsy, there are some things socially, they are stigmatized. The patients are very much occupied with the taboos, like some things that these are due to the curse, these are due to the evil spirits. Even in the urban population, these beliefs holds true for the urban populations. So when it comes in social aspect, there are some part in cases of marriage, the people think of this can be a part in marriage, and there are so many relations have been broken due to coming to the fact that one of the couples have been affected with the this epilepsy, and then the relations has been broken. So these are the bad aspect, bad aspect of the epilepsy when we consider it in society. There are some aspects in society when regarding the driving license. So driving license are not permitted to the people with epilepsy. Recently there are some laws coming out with the endeavor of the some physicians and epileptologists. There are laws that is coming out that help these people that so that they can regain their driving license back after control of the seizure. Now regarding the management of the seizure, we manage most of the seizures with the drugs. About 70% of the people with epilepsy are managed with drugs. When these drugs is not effective, we may go on to the surgery, we may go on to the neurostimulations. So these are the different kinds of therapeutics. Now, before going to the drugs, we have some first aid procedure. When the people affected with seizure, first let the people lie on their sides, and to lie the people on the sides and in the open air, so that the when they vomit, they are not allowed to aspirate their vomitus. So the people must be lied on their back. The spoons, any other hard objects are not allowed in their mouth. So some people try these things to open their mouths, but these again help in the aspirations. Sometimes the caretaker will be beaten. These are the aspects so that the we cannot allow these things when treating the people with epilepsy. Next, if this seizure continues for more than 5 minutes, or this seizure, there are recurrence of seizure very frequently in 1 hour or 2 hours without regaining of consciousness, this is the medical emergency regarding seizure, and this is called status epilepticus. This is very emergency condition, and these must be treated in the hospitals, and the patients with these status epilepticus must be rushed to the hospital. So there are some management of the status in the hospital, that is not the aspect we are going to discuss. And there are some anti-epileptic drugs we use, and there are some precautions, must be precautions, whether their persons have got some liver disease or renal disease, or pregnant or breastfeeding. These are the things we must consider before the prescribing of drugs. Stigma is commonly experienced in the people with epilepsy and the people surrounding these people, surrounding the patient with epilepsy all over the world. And this stigma is act as a great barrier to the treatment of the epilepsy. In India and China particularly, it acts as a barrier to the marriage, as I have mentioned earlier. In Tanzania and other parts of Africa, this is being thought of some curse and some position of the evil spirits or witchcrafts are associated with these things. These are the very difficult situation, difficult barrier we have to break through for the successful treatment of the epilepsy. Sometimes it has been thought that the people with epilepsy are contagious, and these again act as a barrier. So these stigmatization of the epilepsy should be broken if we want to proceed with our successful treatment of the epileptic patients. So I think this is a few words which I want to tell and share with you. And thank you for everyone for listening here. Thank you.